This is Lee Patel. I wrote a piece for JLR entitled Immigrant Populations and Sanctuary Schools. And in this piece, I really take up the question of what it truly means to be a sanctuary space. Sanctuary is often considered to be a safe space, although it is more than that. Its utterance conjures the associations of haven, sanctuary, and even sacred. It's an undeniable fact that schools have never been unilaterally safe spaces or even places of sanctuary. The examples abound through the timeline of the nation. From the United States Indian Bureau of Education that sought to strip indigenous culture from sovereign Native peoples, the outlawing of literacy and schooling for enslaved Black peoples, and to the sequestered substandard English-only mandates that have not so subtly told immigrant populations that it would be only liminally welcomed if they could approximate the practices of U.S.-born monolingual students. This all broadens into question, how can schooling be a place of sanctuary? The Trump presidency has added refreshed xenophobic rhetoric to the vilification of immigrant populations, and many schools and school districts have stepped up to the calling and are pursuing becoming sanctuary spaces. Some schools have refused to cooperate with ICE officials, and others have developed safety plans for their undocumented students. Social movements now and in previous areas have established freedom schools to teach literacy, political education, and bring together collectives. These practices are sometimes overt and sometimes done under the radar in order to create sanctuary from state-served violence. The history of formal teacher preparation and development does not really provide us with those readily accessed practices of freedom-seeking. On the contrary, physical and cultural containment, particularly around language control, are long-standing practices that must be reckoned with to engage sanctuary as collective practice. Finally, sanctuary cannot merely be given or proclaimed as public rhetoric, as some cities have done. Instead, I wonder what sanctuary would look like as a network of teachers and administrators who have learned what being undocumented and/or seen as foreign threat means and feels like for their students. What would that learning necessitate in terms of shifting curriculum from one in which the acquisition of a common language and a new American identity to being actually multicultural and being responsive to the identities, cultures, racial backgrounds, needs, and vulnerabilities found in each classroom? What literacy policies need to be created and put in place to rapidly communicate when immigration raids may be circling and to literally shelter children and youth from that threat knocking at the school door? And perhaps more elusively, what ruptures in the myth that this nation was formed by immigrants must take place for teachers to see migrant children not as charity, but as people who've been made vulnerable by a transnational system of capitalist policies? I believe in the idea of sanctuary, but I believe that we must take it seriously beyond the idea of rhetoric to practice an iterative, reflective commitment to keeping all people safe. Thank you.